أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد، فقال الشيطان لما قضي الأمر: إن الله وعدكم وعد الحق ووعدتكم فأخلفتكم، وما كان لي عليكم من سلطان إلا أن دعوتكم فاستجبتم لي، فلا تلوموني ولوموا أنفسكم. فقال تعالى: قال رب بما أغويتني لأزينن لهم في الأرض ولأغوينهم أجمعين إلا عباد الله المخلصين. صدق الله العظيم. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام: إن الله لا ينظر إلى أجسامكم ولا إلى صوركم، ولكن ينظر إلى قلوبكم وأعمالكم. All praise and thanks is due to one Allah, most gracious, most merciful, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once again, Allah gave us the opportunity and the life and the health, masha'Allah, to come and pray our Salatul Jum'ah. A year ago, we've prayed with some people. This is Ramadan, mashallah, they fasted with us. But today they are in front of us waiting the day of Qiyamah to come, because their life have been taken by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they in Barzakh now to wait for all human beings and jinnat to collect together to stand in front of Allah ta'ala for the judgment day. So when Allah gave us this opportunity that we are still alive, we are fasting, it's a ni'mah from Allah, and doesn't mean that those people, Allah took them, they have did something. Or we are living here, we have did something extra, that's why Allah Ta'ala keep us like this. No. The topic today which I want to speak of is ikhlas, sincerity of our deeds, what we are doing, how should we be connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I give you the conversation which took place between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah conversed with Shaitan, la'anatullahi alayhi, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam alayhi salatu wa salam. وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي خَالِقٌ بَشَرًا مِنْ صَلْصَالٍ مِنْ حَمَيٍ مَسْنُونٍ. Allah ta'ala, he created insan and he blew the ruh, that is Adam alayhi salatu wa salam, which is our forefather. Then after all that, Allah command, he give the amr to all the malaika. Though Shaitan was not a malaika, he was a jinn. But Allah Ta'ala, because he have made so much ibadah, Allah Ta'ala put him among the status of the malaika. So Allah commanded them to make sajda for Shaitan, sajda for Adam alayhi salatu wa salam. Shaitan refused. He said he won't make sajda. Break the command, one commandment of Allah he have broken. Subhanallah, we take a lesson from this also. How many commandments of Allah we insan today, especially the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we break a lot of commandments of Allah, which is the fadil that Allah have given to this Ummah. But still, Allah Ta'ala keep us where we are. Allah never change our place and put us in another place. But one command of Allah, Shaitan have broken, subhanallah, by not performing sajda to Allah, Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah took him out from that noble company, that is the company of the malaika. Allah took him out from there, and Allah Ta'ala disgraced him. So when Allah disgraced him, take him out from that position, now he told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know what, Allah? فَأَنْذِرْنِي إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. Oh Allah, please can you keep me until the day of when you taking the last person life from this dunya. So Allah Ta'ala accepted. He said, no problem, you can stay like this on this earth. So what did he told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? قَالَ رَبِّي بِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي لَأُزَيِّنَنَّ لَهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَأُغْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. So oh Allah, you know what? How you have misled me. I will beautify this dunya. I will take these people, that is insan, I will take them away from your commandment to follow you, not to fast, not to give zakat, not to have iman on you, and not to have even sincerity on you. Anything they must be doing, like how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained to us also, إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَهُوَ خَادِعُهُمْ وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ قَامُوا كُسَالَى يُرَاؤُونَ النَّاسَ وَلَا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. So you will find the munafiq, Allah ta'ala save one and all, they will pray salah by saying Allah Akbar, one takbir. But if imam is reading four rakaat of salah, subhanallah, their mind only come back when the imam makes salam. What is that? The mind is not there in that salah. Now you make two rakaat of salah, for example. Now shaitan is not with us, he's in prison, that is in Ramadan. They have jailed him, so he's not with us. But still, how can we correct our salah? Imagine 60 years from the age one, you go up till 68, 70 years, now you come in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your deeds become haba mansura, there is nothing for you on the day of Qiyamah, but you say to Allah, I have did so much, I have made a lot of deeds, I've made a lot of nafil, I've made tahajjud, I've made tarawih, but at the end, I don't have nothing. How? Because we are making that salah like we are stealing in salah. How did a person steal in salah? يُرَاؤُونَ النَّاسُ وَلَا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. He's just looking around and he don't remember Allah except very little. So he's just saying, Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. That is why to get the knowledge of the basic of Islam is faridah upon every Muslim. We have to get that. At least to know what is the meaning of Subhana Rabbi al-A'la, to know the oneness of Allah, to know the greatness of Allah. That's why you are standing, you say, Allahu Akbar. Allah is greater than business. Allah is greater than myself. Allah is greater than my family. Allah is greater than anything on this earth. Either is vehicles, either is the luxuries we are living in. Allah is greater than all that. That's why you put in Allahu Akbar. And after the first thing you read, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim, you read Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. That is, you are praising Rabbil Alameen. Who is that? Sustainer, nourisher, cherisher, most powerful, Malikul Mulk, king of all the king, tu'til mulka man tasha, he give the kingdom to any person we wish, wa tu'izzu man tasha, respect, dignity, honor is from Allah, wa tudhillu man tasha, Allah Ta'ala also disgrace any person we wish, وَتَجَلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرُ إِنَّكَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. سبحان الله, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all good lies in the hands of Allah. تُولِجُ اللَّيْلَ فِي النَّهَارِ, Allah changed the day and the night. وَتُولِجُ النَّهَارَ فِي اللَّيْلِ, Allah put, now we are in the day, some part of the world they are still sleeping. Allah Ta'ala never wake them up. So this day is coming and is going from us and the night is coming. Somewhere the night is coming, the day is going. So this is all changed by Allah Ta'ala. يَرْزُكُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ, and Allah Ta'ala give risk, sustenance to any person who may wish. So this is, you are putting Allahu Akbar, Alhamdulillah, He Rabbil Alameen. You are saying, Ya Allah, you are Rabbil Alameen. Praise be to you. So you are standing in front of that Rabb, that is Allah, we have to recognize. They asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is iman? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that is ikhlas. Because the person who bring iman in Allah, he fear Allah, he recognize Allah, he say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Allah is the most gracious, most merciful. The mercy of the world, Allah Ta'ala give it to both the Muslim, Mu'min, and a Kafir also, Christian also, he also get that benefit of the mercy of this dunya Allah Ta'ala is giving. You will find a person is in a luxury life, that is a Muslim, and the same you will find a Kafir also, he is staying in a luxury life. Allah give wealth to a Muslim, and he give that wealth also to that Kafir. That Muslim, that Mu'min, he sleep comfortably. Allah Ta'ala give it to a Kafir also, he sleep comfortably also. So that Rahmah of dunya, Rahman, Allah Ta'ala, subhanallah, he have given to both of them. But Ar-Rahim, that is in Akhirah, Subhanallah, that is the difference. Now Shaitan himself, he have cleared this place there. When he told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَأُغْوِيَنَّهُمْ كُلُّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ, I will mislead all of them. That is all the insan. I will put them into that direction which Allah you don't want. So he replied to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, إِلَّا عِبَادُ اللَّهِ مِنْهُمُ الْمُخْلَصِينَ. Except the chosen servants of yours, whom you know that, subhanallah, their salah, they are doing for you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Their fasting, they are doing for you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Their dhikr, they are doing for you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Their remembrance of Allah, anywhere they are. يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والأرض. So either they are standing, they are lying down on their comfortable beds, but still they don't forget about Allah, they remember Allah, and they make sure that subhanallah, they fear that day they're going to meet, that is Allah, they will stand in front of Allah, for Allah is going to question them their deeds. So these deeds Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, رِجَالٌ لَا تُلْهِيهِمْ تِجَارَةٌ وَلَا بَيْعٌ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَإِقَامِ الصَّلَاةِ وَإِيتَاءِ الزَّكَاةِ يَخَافُونَ يَوْمًا تَتَقَلَّبُ فِيهِ الْقُلُوبُ وَالْأَبْصَارُ. You'll find in the life of the Sahaba al-Kiram, Radwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in, even they are making businesses, they remember Allah because of that ikhlas, that is the sincerity they got from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he told Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa alim, if you giving out sadaqah, even though it is small like half of a date, you do it with the sincerity of Allah, it is better than you give so much that on the day of Qiyamah you will not have nothing. So you perform so much nafil salah, people see you, mashallah, is performing lot of long rakat, long sajdas, long ruku, but at the end, why is doing that? Because people must see that I am performing this salah correctly. I am giving that zakat so that people can say, no, this man is a generous person. It is the way in Miswat Sharif, Allah Ta'ala, Rasulullah mentioned, there will be three categories of people, they will come in front of Allah on the day of Qiyamah. So when they come to Allah, Allah will ask them, that is a wealthy person whom Allah Ta'ala have favored him of some wealth of this dunya. Allah will ask him, the wealth I have given you, how did you use it? He will tell, oh Allah, I have spent it so many places. I have built masajid, I have feed a lot of poor people. And this is Ramadan also. Shaitan is not with us now. Most of us, alhamdulillah, we discharging our zakat this time. Shaitan is not with us, but we got the mind that, hey, I am doing this. So now we explain him to everyone also, mashallah, they must know that, yes, the ikhlas of giving the charity or doing a deed openly to encourage the other people also to give, there is nothing wrong with that. But the person who is giving, because people must say of his generosity, this is what we're talking here. And he don't have the ikhlas with him that he is doing for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Shaitan is not there, but the mind is there, the heart is there, it's complaining, yes, I am doing this. People must see that I am the one who have sponsored this thing. People must see that I am the one who is doing all these activities, what is happening. So at the end, what will happen? On the day of Qiyamah, when he comes, Allah will tell him, yes, you have did all this, but subhanAllah, there's nothing for you here. Go and request your reward from those people you were doing for. So now the next person will come, who is that? An alim. Who is an alim? Allah gave him the knowledge of the Quran. He have learned tafsir, he have lot of hadith. A hadith, he came in front, he's teaching a lot of people. He met a lot of people who fast, mashallah. But why is he doing all these things? People must see that, mashallah, he give the best of all the lectures. He read best of all the Quran. He tafsir the Quran in the best way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala got no business of that. Because why? Allah want those people, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينِ. So those who complete their religion and they make their things and they make all their direction of their deeds is for only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the last person will come, that is a mujahid. He fought in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He have made a lot of sacrifice until they have slain him in the path of Allah. But what will happen? He do this, people must say, no, mashallah, he's a warrior, subhanallah, he did this, he did that. But on the day of Qiyamah, Allah will tell him also, go and request your reward from those people. When we see our fasting also, Allah Ta'ala mentioned, كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم. At the end Allah said لعلكم تتقون. How can we get that God fearing? How can we fear Allah? That is why we are fasting now. Now the poor people before, subhanAllah, we got everything in our fridge. We can open it anytime. We got money in our pocket. There's a lot of restaurants. You can go there and buy whatever you want. But you are staying away from all this for the sake of Allah. Imagine you don't do it for the sake of Allah. At the end, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell us, before Ramadan came, he told the Sahaba, there will be people coming, they will be fasting, subhanAllah. They will only stay away from food. They will be in hunger. And they will stand the whole Tarawih. They will make tahajjud. They will read a lot of Quran. Subhanallah, nothing will be beneficial for them. But because why? They don't have sincerity, number one. And those kind of people, subhanAllah, they spoil their fasting. How they spoil their fasting? Maybe by breaking the fast with the haram food. Maybe by backbiting, a lot of backbiting. Some ulamas are in the opinions that this will break fast. Some ulamas are in the opinion that no, but it decreases the fasting of a person. Subhanallah. So backbiting, we should stay away from that. Talking of lies, we should stay away from that. If you get in 50% or you get in 20% or 10% of that profit by speaking the truth, it's better not to make 100% but not speaking the truth on that business. Allah Ta'ala will not have any business with that fasting also. So Allah chose us, Allah selected us to be in the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah have given us this chance of this Ramadan. Imagine you have made a lot of nafil salah. Allah will reward you just like you are fat, you are making farad. If you make nafil, Allah reward you as farad. Subhanallah. If you make farad, Allah multiply it 70 times. So that person who made it, who want Allah want us to get 70 times more reward, we want to make it zero. How we will do that? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always and the Sahabatul Kiram radhiyallahu ta'ala alayhim ajma'in, they take a lot of profit and cost. They were very cautious of their deeds, what they were doing. How we can safeguard our deeds? Before you do anything, remember, why am I doing this action? Remember the action. Why am I doing this action? Whilst you are doing it, remember I'm doing it for the sake of Allah. After you finish, make istighfar so that Allah can accept that deeds from you. Allah is the one, Umar radiallahu anhu said, if I know that Allah have accepted one of my deeds, then I got no fear. If Allah have accepted my deeds, I got no fear. Because we all don't know what is in front there on the day of the hour. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, when they asked him, when he was dying, he was crying. They asked him, oh Abu Hurairah, you have did a lot of good deeds. Subhanallah, you memorized a lot of hadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So why are you fear? Why are you crying? He said, this is dunya is very small. Imagine the last person to enter into Jannah, his Jannah will be greater than this dunya 10 times. So how big is Akhirah? How big is Jannah? Subhanallah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he went for Isra wal Mi'raj, when the Mi'raj he found Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa sallam, he told him, go and tell your ummah, Jannah is an open garden, there is nothing there. Subhanallah, he told him, the fields are empty. By meaning tasbih, Allah Ta'ala will be planting so much trees for you there. You make one, subhanAllah, Allah put a tree for you in Jannah. Imagine you read one Surah Fatiha, how many reward is encompassed in that Surah Fatiha only? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَا أَقُولُ أَلِفْ لَا مِمْ عَرْفٌ. One alif is not harf, وَلَكِنْ أَلِفٌ حَرْفٌ وَلَامٌ حَرْفٌ وَمِيمٌ حَرْفٌ. If you read in Quran also, he said, I don't say one alif is a harf, but alif lam mim is not one harf, but alif is a harf, lam is a harf, mim is a harf. If you read only one alif, Allah reward you 10 hasana, and Allah Ta'ala can increase it anyhow he wants. Allah Ta'ala is like that. Allah Ta'ala can increase our deeds anyhow he wants. That's why Allah Ta'ala gave us that. You make one hasana, Allah Ta'ala will reward you 10 times. A person commit a sin, Allah Ta'ala tell the angels, wait, if that person have to return himself back to Allah by making istighfar. And this is a great opportunity for us in Ramadan. We are fasting, our duas are accepted. We don't have malice, we don't have jealousy, we don't have any hatred. Allah Ta'ala take this from our heart by reading a lot of Quran and making dhikr and a lot of nafil salah. Allah have chose this ummah and selected them from among the other nations from Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. Till this time, Allah has given us such an opportunity. لَأَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Allah gave us guidance always. وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ. Make istighfar to Allah. Come back to Allah. Perform lot of deeds. Our religion is that we don't say to Allah, we just say Allah must curse us, Allah must punish us before we leave this world. No. Rasulullah found a Sahabi, he is asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah to take all the sins from him, that means punishing him in dunya before he go to akhirah. Rasulullah catch him, don't ask Allah for that. Say, Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhab an-nar. Oh Allah, give us the best of this dunya and give us the best of the akhirah. What is the best of this dunya? عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فلنحيينه حياة طيبة. Allah Ta'ala will give that person the best of lives, that person who follow the commandment of Allah. Let's try it. You will see the feeling. You won't worry people are there, people are not there. Any deeds you are doing because of sincerity, you won't mind it. Because your heart knows that these deeds I am doing only for the pleasure of Allah Ta'ala, and my reward is only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. We don't wait for anybody. Today we give sadaqah. Today we give zakat. We do something. We are waiting for that person to praise us. We are waiting for that person to thank us. Allah ta'ala said, no. Just say, لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ. We don't need anything of that, of your jaza or your shukur, that you are thanking us. You give and you move on. Know that that reward for you is multiplying and is going front and front. لا تبطلوا صدقاتكم بالمن والعطاء. Allah Ta'ala tells us also, we don't give that sadaqah, we don't give that gift, subhanallah, we go and destroy it by explaining it to everyone also. So this is it. Allah Ta'ala chose us to select, and shaitan already he told Allah, I will mislead everyone illa ibad Allah al-mukhlasin. I don't have any power on those people whom you have selected, you have chosen, and they have made their deeds for only you. Then Allah from there, that ones, you are the one who have chosen them. May Allah Ta'ala choose us and put us among those people whom you know that they're doing their deeds for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they are mukhlasin. Allah Ta'ala himself, he has chosen them and selected them. And those people will not make any sunnah except that they get direct connection with Allah. That is, they say, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. They are remembering Allah. They are telling Allah, Rahman Rahim, you are the most gracious, most merciful. Maliki Yawmiddin, O Allah, you are the master of the day of judgment. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in. They are remembering Allah frequently because this every rakat of our salah, we read this surah al-Fatiha. At least when we don't know this, but we have to go to one alim to explain us this, to know the meaning of only surah al-Fatiha or the surahs we have commonly used in our salah. To know that meaning, it increases our remembrance of Allah in salah, and it always draw the connection between us and Allah. Imagine you put your forehead down, you are saying Subhana Rabbi al-A'la, but where is that Subhana Rabbi al-A'la? Maybe it's not even completed. You just twist the tongue, then get off from that. Subhanallah, this great Ramadan come, then it pass like that. Subhanallah, that Subhana Rabbi al-A'la is not correct. That Subhana Rabbi al-Azim is not correct. That Surah Fatiha is reading with a rush. That Qul Huwallahu Ahad is reading with a rush. When we making tasbih with a rush also, Subhanallah. This is an opportunity, and Allah Ta'ala have selected us and given us this opportunity to read that the time of our business when the customer is not there, subhanAllah. How many tasbih we can make? And even the customer comes, we can still make tasbih with our hands by connecting with ourselves with Allah always. When the dhikr of Allah is with us, tilawat of Quran is with us, and nafil salah is with us, sunnah salah is with us, farad salah is with us, it will be very easy to be connected with Allah directly always also. Because why? Remembrance of Allah is there. Now even you take out hundred thousands of rands, you take out hundred thousands of dollars, you give it to the path of Allah subhanAllah, you know that I am with Allah. Always, because anywhere you are going, Allah is in your mind. You are always cautious about the remembrance of Allah. You don't worry, people are there, people are not there. You are with Allah, malaika are just writing. Anything you do, the malaikas are writing. Either from the right side or in the left side, kiram and katibin, their duty is there, they have written it. Don't wipe it out with subhanAllah, either in jealousy or either in show or either to publish it to the people, so that people must know that I am the one doing this. May Allah Ta'ala guide us, may Allah Ta'ala choose us and put us in the servants who are mukhlasin inshaAllah. وَمَا عَلَيْنَا إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We thank Sheikh for his lecture today. Just two announcements. On behalf of the Pretoria Islamic Society and the Institute for Islamic Services, we wish everybody a blessed Ramadan. Second announcement, we at the Institute for Islamic Services once again appeal to all for zakat and lita funds this Ramadan for our ongoing projects throughout the year, namely medical and dental center, daily feeding schemes, daily adult literacy classes, daily madrasa classes, daycare centers, monthly grocery vouchers for 140 families, and many other projects. All our projects are carried out in Lodium and surrounding areas, and anybody wishing to see our projects may do so at their convenience by just calling and contacting us. Inshallah, we will be coming around during Ramadan. Jazakallah.